Good morning, everyone. This morning we are going to shed some light on an economic phenomenon known as Dutch disease. It is not actually a disease like zoonotic disease or humanotic disease that we suffer from, diabetes or COVID or cancer, but it is economic disease. When economy suffers from this kind of phenomena that we are going to elaborate is known as Dutch disease. It was first coined in 1977 by Economist magazine, and since then everywhere this word is buzzing. Why it is known as Dutch disease, not American disease, not England or English disease, not German or Indian disease? Because it started out in Netherlands. It started out in Netherlands in around 1957, when Netherlands actually discovered the huge reserves of oil. Now government or industrialists or users, sellers, buyers, no one had any kind of idea of how to tap this much petroleum, this much resource. So when the resources in your nation are either too much or too little, then the demand, then you can call it a Dutch disease. For example, the demand of vaccine right now, we all know demand of vaccine is right now probably 100% or 100 times more than what we have. But we don't have that many vaccine available. We don't have that much vaccine compounds or contents available. We cannot actually manufacture that much vaccine. That is called Dutch disease, because people need 1 million shots of vaccine in India, in any one state. 1 million. But government can provide only 10,000. That is called Dutch disease. In short, when the demand of anything actually rises astronomically, but supply is not there. Either the raw material is not there, or capital is not there, or manufacturing plants are not there, or manpower, like white collar, blue collar, pink collar people, are not there, or government does not provide, or government cannot provide ample amount of facilities to the companies. Whatever the reason, say for example, Indians are demanding 100 million doses of vaccine every day, but government can provide only 10 million. That is called Dutch disease. So whenever the Dutch disease occurs, what actually happens is this, that economy actually, demand-wise, economy rises, but supply-wise does not rise. Demand-wise, economy rising. Demand of every single thing is so astronomical, so skyrocketing, that you can supply demand of the people 24 hours a day, or 24 times 7 times 365. But you don't have that much supply. Like I gave you the example of vaccine again. Demand of the vaccine all over the world is probably 100 million shots every day. But we don't have 100 million shots every day. So that is known as that we actually face Dutch disease. I have chosen 4 points for this phenomenon for you to understand it properly, comprehend comprehensively, because it's a very important, very vital subject for your MBA, for your economic understanding. Point number one is boom in demand, bust in supply. Demand is booming everywhere. Demand is going up. I give you the example of my street, where 4 places the construction work or renovation work has been going on, but workers are not there. Same team of workers work at my place for a couple of days, then they go to my neighbor for a couple of days, then they go to third neighbor for a couple of days, and this way, instead of 1 month or 6 weeks work, has been going on for the last 12, 13 weeks, and is still not over. What is this? This is Dutch disease, where demand is astronomically high, supply of people, supply of capital, supply of raw material, supply of resources, supply of nothing is available in commensuration with demand. Say there's a demand of 100 pieces of computer, we can say, but Dell produces only 50 pieces a day. That is called Dutch disease, because Dell can provide only 50, where the demand of the computer is 100 in the market. So when the demand of anything in the market is astronomical and supply is nosedived, that kind of phenomenon is known as Dutch disease, according to Economist magazine, that actually coined this phrase in 1977, because in Netherlands, means a Dutch nation, where this kind of condition, this kind of phenomenon was first introduced or first noticed. Point number two is government's inability to supply raw material. As we all know, most of the raw material is always supplied by the government. You cannot just go into the forest or in the wilderness, cut down the trees and chop up whatever you want as a raw material and bring it by the truckload to your factory and recycle it. No. You have to have government license, you have to have government backing, you have to have government's permission to have ample amount of raw material, then you can have raw material. Now here, what happens is this. In the Dutch disease, that demand of your product in the market is, say, for example, 90%, but the raw material supply is only 70%. So there's a gap of 20% supply that you cannot supply to the market. What is known as Dutch disease. Point number three, jobs are ubiquitous, workers are scant. It actually applies to people too. Most of the time, what happens is this, that blue collar, white collar, pink collar, first category, and all kinds of people who we need to work in our companies, in our factories, they are not available. Or if they are available, but they are about 70 to 80% available. We always work with a 20% gap. And when this thing happens, then our business, our production, our manufacturing, our supply to the market, every single thing suffers. And that is known as Dutch disease, when your company, your factory, your manufacturing plant needs, say for example, 5,000 people to work, but you can get only 4,000. That is 80%. And you are actually running your company with 20% lacking, 20% deficiency. And that 20% deficiency is going to reflect on your business, that you are not actually deriving 100% business, but only 80% business is 80% business is only derived by you, not 100%. Point number four is supply side economy is at the nadir. Demand side economy, supply side economy. Two sides economy can be considered. Demand side economy, when the demand is too high and the supply is almost in parity, in commensuration, and there's nothing going on. Say, for example, we in our locality, construction work is going on and we demand 100 bags of cement and we can get it. That is demand side economy. We should not have any kind of problem getting 100 bags of cement. But then again, you think for a minute, we need 100 bags. then we can get only 70 beds. That means supply side economic problem. Means the supply is not enough. We can go 3 or 4 or 5 places, 10 beds from here or 20 beds from there. This way we can have 100 beds. That is causing Dutch disease. So you remember, Dutch disease is a very simple, very, very easy to understand, easy to comprehend term. Simple thing is, simple definition to understand is, when the demand of anything is very high, but supply is not there. When the supply is short, supply is scant, people are scant, capital is scant, raw material is scant, and all those things, whatever the things that a businessman or manufacturer needs to supply the goods are not available in the market, either by the we can say the inability of the government or inability of the nature or whatever the reason, either people are not willing to work or the capital is not available. And due to that, when the supply side economic crunch occurs, when you cannot supply the demand of the consumers, that is known as Dutch disease. Thank you very much for listening. Talk to you again tomorrow. Until then, God bless everyone on this planet.